Citadel Forged With Fire describes itself as a massive online sandbox RPG featuring elements of magic, spellcasting, building, exploring, and crafting. As a newly minted apprentice of the magical arts, you'll set off to the dangerous world of Ignus, tame mighty beasts, forge alliances, explore uncharted territories, and fight for dominance. This game came to Steam Early Access on the 26th of July 2017, and as of making this video, has mixed reviews on Steam. So, quick look at the options menu, let's see what we're dealing with. Not a whole lot of options so far. Let's crank the field of view up to max. Always looks good. Everything's on epic right now. Sounds good. Let's jump in. So based off these servers, it seems like the maximum amount of players in a world seems to be between 40 and 50 at the moment. It doesn't seem like there's a whole lot of character customization at the moment. Just a few head presets, a few different hairstyles, and different colors of skin, hair, nails, and eyes. Right, there we go. I think that should do the job. The game's given me three choices of spawn location: the west, the east, or in the middle. Let's spawn in the middle. So this is where we spawn. It seems like we spawn out of lava. Interesting. I had to get rid of the motion blur because it didn't look very good. Well, let's just go around and start gathering things, as with every survival type game. Hello? I don't think we can actually damage this guy. I don't think it's the most visually impressive survival game I've played. There's definitely a lot of others that look a lot better. Is this some kind of barrier? Oh, I think it's a safe zone barrier. Right. Does punching trees actually give you stuff? Doesn't seem like it does in this game. Nice. In some areas, this game looks really gorgeous. Like now, for example, the sun setting, the light glistening off the plants. We found our first monster, a wild elk. Seems to be lagging a little bit. It's probably because I'm playing on the online servers. So now I'm level 3. I can open up the skill menu with K, and it's going to give me a bunch of different options. Items, utility, structures, and spells. So I think the first thing I want to make is a staff. So I'm going to learn how to make that using knowledge points. As with most survival games, when I level up, I can also spend points on health, mana, damage, or carrying capacity. We're going to make Staff of the Forest. So you can craft staffs quite early on. I think I'm definitely going to need to restart again on a new server. It's far too laggy. Die, wolf. Hello? 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 Okay, Mr. Wolf. Just stand there and let me attack you then. We got attacked, apparently. So this time I'm making my own server because the other ones are way too laggy. Let's crank the player limit up. PvP server. Crank all of the experience things up really fast so we can progress really quickly. Oh, wow. I didn't realize it, but this game actually has a third-person mode. You just press tab to swap in between. This one's going to be a pain in the ass to hit. He's just running around. I'm up for a challenge. Oh, get fucking wrecked, dear. I'm quite enjoying the staff combat in this game. Similar to Dark and Light, you just kind of fire a projectile. Very wide open landscape here. Can you swim in this game? You can indeed. One-handed swimming with a staff. This guy's a god. Let's see just how far my fireball can travel. There's a horse over there. We bloody missed. Let's try again. We got him. Oh my god, the fireball abilities travel so far. That's super fun. So this is my haste ability. It makes me go super fast. So at level 10, I unlock a broomstick, so I need to go level up a little bit. That sounds really fun. Crafting things gives you a ton of XP in this game, so that's one way to level up very quickly. Frame rate in this game is really not that good, though. Hovering around 30 FPS with a 1080 Ti graphics card. Not too impressive. Definitely not very optimized at all. Oh my god, this sprite deals some damage? Fucking run. Bloody hell, look at this thing. Dude, that is so creepy. I don't like sprites. We fucking died. Got some crowberries. Now I can make myself some health potions. Much needed. Look at that creepy little fuck. That'll teach you to mess with me, Mr. Sprite. So something I've learned is I don't have to charge up my ability for it to do maximum damage. I can just spam my fire ability and it works just fine. Any other poor forest dwellers to kill? Oh, dude, there's an undead! What's an undead doing here? A level 12 bear. Do I have the damage to take him out? I'm gonna struggle. Oh, never mind, I'm a bloody mage. Oh, there's another one! I've walked into a bear nest. Do my magic speed ability. Okay, so out of nowhere, there's a level 38 flame dragon. I do not have a chance against this monster. I run. You just stand there, Mr. Flame Dragon. I'm slowly going to kill you. The dragon may be a high level, but he certainly doesn't have high IQ. Bye, dudes. That just gave me a whole level killing that thing. Dragon scale, iron ingots, mana vial. We've found the level 17 sprites. Fuck this, dude. Dude, this is bloody intense. Using my mana ability. Dude, no! There's something going on in the background. Are these other players? This is my server, though. Oh, it's a bandit orc. Okay, it's not another player. The AI isn't stupid. They certainly run in a way that makes it very hard to hit. Apparently, we're building the broomstick, but there's a bit of delay for some unknown reason. Now I can press F. Nice, dude! And we can shoot and fly on our broomstick at the same time. Dude, that's so cool. We're going so fast as well. Now, this is what makes Citadel really unique. I've never seen a survival game with broomsticks before. I can just do drive-bys on poor defenseless animals. Forest Guardian. He's not going to be able to touch me on my broomstick, is he? Wingardium Leviosa, motherfucker. There we go. And now we can loot it while staying on our broom. This broom feels incredibly overpowered. Whilst I'm up here, I'm going to see if there's any limit on the range of your abilities. So I'm going to fire this fireball and we're going to try and chase it. If it lands and hits the floor, then there's no limit. It does indeed. That is bloody cool. So I can just shoot things from one side of the map to the other. And that'll actually hit. Die, little bear. Nothing you can do about it, is there? The graphics of this game don't look very nice when you're above everything, looking down at the world. It does look quite ugly and dated. The inverted tower. Let's go down into the inverted tower and see what we're dealing with. Oh, dude, it is a dungeon. Level 25 demon bat monsters. I feel like you're probably going to want to have a party with you to do this. Let's just fly through this dungeon and see what's inside. So you've got a bunch of undead. You've got, oh, flying spooky monsters. I'm frozen. We run. We die. One thing I do appreciate is that when you die, you keep your stuff and you keep your weapons and potions. Doesn't really feel as punishing to die in this survival game as others that I've played. Let's see if we can re-equip our broom if we start falling midair. So, we fall in. We coming in hot. You can indeed. That's nice. Right, so let's test out my new ability, Lightning Bolts, it's called. So it's quite a short range ability and it's a channeled drain kind of ability. It's not that good, to be honest. Oh, there's a bloody treasure chest here. Apprentice magic ring. That's what we need. So now we're currently checking out the building in this game. Seems really simple at the moment. Everything just kind of clicks together. Okay, you actually get a lot of XP just for building your house. I have to say, this game makes it so easy to build houses and structures. Never had such an easy time doing this before in a survival game. I've been working on this house for about 5 minutes and it's already almost done. Let's make a little throne here. Some fucking monsters attacking my house, the little bastard. Respawn stone, that's going to be bloody helpful. We can also put ourselves a chest down. There we go, let's put some stairs here. There it is, my base is all built. So now it's daytime, I'm going to give you a little tour of my house. So this is what it looks like from the outside. As you can see, you've got windows. We've built stairs leading up to it. We've got a door here, two torches. Open the door, walk through. You've got a health pool here. I can just stand in this and get my health back. Mana pool here, so that does the same for mana. Here's my throne. I've got a dead bear underneath it. This is a respawn point. Very helpful indeed. And a storage chest. Really didn't take me long to build this house, so I'm very impressed. Another thing I've just learned about Citadel is you can quickly swap between two different weapon sets. So currently I've got a staff set and a fist weapon set, each of which have different abilities tied to them. So this is one of my fist weapon abilities. It shoots a beam of death out of it. Another thing I've also discovered is that there's two different types of speed for your broom. If you press shift, your broom kind of goes super fast. Unlock fast travel, okay. So there's different towers throughout the world that you can fast travel to. Interesting. Okay, so as we're going north, we're encountering a lot of flying dragons at the moment. Come at me, dragon. Oh, it's level 49. It has a lot of health. Look at that corpse just flop to the floor. All right, this is the dragon I want to take out. I'm just going to use my draining attack. It's a lot easier to attack it with this. Oh, fuck, dude! Oh, God, my frame rate's not great. This is very difficult. He is flying off into the distance. Come back, Mr. Dragon. He's flying across the whole bloody map. He is flying from one side of the map to the other to escape. And now he's disappeared! It looks like we found a snowy area. Nice to see there's different biomes in this game, because I have to say most of the world does look very samey at the moment. Not a very interesting world. Some kind of snow fire demon. What level is it? Level 50. I feel like the ability to just fly above the monsters and wreck them from the air when they can't even attack you is a little bit overpowered. Okay, we killed it and it gave us an entire level. So this level 50 monster's basically given us legendary equipment. We just came across some random totem pole-like thing and it's got lots of super high-level monsters around it. Okay, the game's bloody freezing. The frame rate is not good. Lots of loot from these monsters, and now I can loot a treasure chest. This is what they were protecting. This is where I want to go next. There's a giant volcano in the middle of the map. So I just flew into the center of this volcano, and I noticed a doorway. There's a dungeon right at the middle. I'm surprised not to see any monsters here yet. Is this just a place to farm rune crystal? Is it not even a dungeon? Dragon, it's time to die. Just stay still. And be a good dragon. I don't know what the point of these dragons are because you just attack them and they run away. I'm sure you can tell from up here, but the view distance in this game is huge. Apparently in this game, you can tame wild monsters and use them for mounts. So that's something I'm gonna look into. Apparently to tame a creature, I need to use the pacify spell and drain its energy. We're taming an imp, apparently. Let's give it a try. It's got a little circle around its portrait. I think that's the taming progress. I can't really get any closer because I'll die, but it seems like you can just out of range it with your broomstick, as with everything in this game. So I tamed the imp. I can make it follow me and defend me. It doesn't seem like there's any option to actually mount the imp, unfortunately. Here we go. This is my tamed monster defending me aggressively. He's just killing this fucking undead. Let's see if we can tame a bear. There we go. We'll kill its family. We've got no use for them. Aren't I a heartless fuck? Barry the bear. Put the saddle in the monster's inventory. And now it's wearing a saddle. So now, we can just mount the bear. And I've still got the demon imp that I tamed as well. I wonder if you can just make an army of tamed monsters in this game. So my bear's left click is some kind of swipe. And its right click is to stand up on its back legs. The bear does seem to be somewhat useless in combat. He is only a level 15 though, the poor bastard. I order you to attack my minions. They're trying to defend me. They're doing a shit job of it, but they're trying. I flew halfway across the map and you can see Barry the bear in the distance. Being oh so loyal, running across to come and greet me. Are these creatures in the distance just randomly fighting? The orcs are attacking the horse. The dragons are attacking the orcs. This mountain giant's just walking around trying to mount the horse by the looks of it. Barry the bear died! No, Barry! So now I'm at the point where I've been playing Citadel Forged with Fire for a few hours, and I feel like I've got a decent enough first impressions of the game. So as always with this series, we're now going to talk about the pros and the cons, the good things and the bad things, starting with the pros. Citadel Forged with Fire was, to my surprise, a decent amount of fun for an early access game. I like how it wasn't too heavy on the typical survival elements we've come to expect, such as looking after hunger, thirst, sleeping, and energy. I've never really found that stuff to be overly fun, so the fact it doesn't seem to be present in this game is a positive for me. I also really enjoyed the combat, especially the staff abilities, firing projectiles and predicting your enemy's movements. It feels like the game gives you a decent sense of progression through crafting better gear, unlocking better spells, and increasing your character's stats. I actually found the building in Citadel to control quite well, and it wasn't too tedious to make myself a base. I love the taming aspect to this game. I think you'll probably have a lot of fun just going around taming different monsters seeing what can be used as a mount and what makes the best bodyguard. The user interface was quite simple and wasn't too busy. It doesn't take long to become familiar with this. You get a really cool sense of freedom once you unlock your broomstick that I've never felt from other survival games. That being said, it does make you feel like you're able to cheese some of the higher level monsters by just flying out of range from them. Visually, Citadel isn't the best looking game you'll ever play, and some of the textures do look a bit dated. Perhaps this will improve over the game's development though. The online servers were really laggy to the point where I didn't want to play them, gathering was unresponsive, killing monsters was highly delayed, and there was quite a bit of desync. The overall performance of the game wasn't very good at all, but that's somewhat to be expected from an early access game. Hopefully better optimization will come closer to the full release. Overall, not a bad game. I'm typically not much of a survival fan, but this one I had a decent amount of fun with, and I think I'd have enjoyed it even more with a group of friends to play with. But that's it for this video, guys. I do hope you enjoyed it or found it useful. As always, let me know your thoughts on Citadel in the comments below, and consider subscribing for more first impressions videos. Thanks for watching. I hope you all have a great day, and I'll see you again really soon.